All right, a very good afternoon to everyone. Thanks for having me in this conference. My name is Kuei Ting In. I am an undergrad from University Malaysia Sabah, and I would like to share with you a study entitled Parenting Style, Self-Concept and Peer Influence on Student Misconduct Behavior in Malacca, Malaysia. Just a brief introduction. The issues of misconduct in students show a growing trend over time in our past decades. And it has been an issue discussed by our country leaders, educational ministries, our teachers, and also our parents. And just share with you a little statistic by our Malaysian Criminal Prevention Foundation shows that 295 students were involved in a very serious case, including murder case. And 1.5 criminals in each of the 1,000 students and 1,836 criminal cases were reported, with 3,383 students detained. And these issues has been disrupt the efforts of Ministry of Education to produce knowledgeable and moral individuals in the Malaysian society. And there are some examples of misconduct behavior. I categorize them into three, which is the first group, smoking cigarettes, skipping school, fighting against teachers, vandalism, on destroying the public utilities, quarrel with each other. These are the behaviors that commonly under the disciplinary case in school. And the second group is a more serious misconduct behavior involving gangsterism, run away from home, watching pornography videos. And the third categories were concerned with the criminal offense, such as killing, raping, child abandonment, prostitution, drug abuse, and promiscuity. And there are several factors that contributing to parenting style. And we would like to highlight the first one is the parenting style. Misconduct behavior are often associated with the dysfunctional of family system. This is because the self-development and personality of our students are highly dependent on their family of origins. In other words, how the parents nurture them will shape their students' behaviors and their personalities. In this way, the parenting style that practiced by our students' parents will affect their behaviors in later or in futures. So there are several kinds of parenting style which are less favorable because it could lead to several negative issues such as deviant behavior, antisocial behavior, and of course, misconduct behaviors. These parenting styles are authoritarian parenting style, permissive, and neglectful parenting style. And the child's misconduct behavior are one of the products of the negative parenting style. So, and moving on to our next self variables concerning factors that contribute to misconduct behavior is self-concept. And those students with a positive self-concept are always receiving a good care and attention from their parents, teachers, friends, and people around them. They are often in a positive mood, confidence, and have a full trust in themselves to perform tasks. They are also optimistic and are always willing to accept the opinions and criticism of others. Unlikely, students with a more negative self-concept are always in a bad, in a negative mood, lower confidence, and mistrust. They are not pessimistic, and they are less likely to accept people's opinion and criticism, else they will react in a more aggressive way. In talking about the aggressive issues, and some students with a negative self-concept, they are more likely to hide their negative emotion or low confidence in an aggressive manner, meaning that they are inferior, they are unconfident about themselves, but they conduct or they involve in misconduct behaviors just to show that they are very confident or to overcome the inferiority feelings. So there are third variables that influence on students' misconduct behavior, which is the peer influence. And the peer influence is very critical and is actually a neutral term. It can be influence our students both positively and negatively. And students are easily being affected because they are just at the age of establishing their social identities. They are trying to explore themselves, their values, their principles, and in the process of explorations, they tend to conform to their peers' norm, mimicking their peers' both positive and negative behaviors. This means that if the students they engage with the peer that have practiced positive behavior or habits, they will be influenced to practice and have a good behavior. And vice versa, if they engage with people with have a record of misconduct behavior, their tendency for them to conform to these peer norms is very high. So there are several objectives that we would like to highlight in these studies. There are four actually. The first is to identify the most dominant misconduct behavior among our school students in Malaysia. And the second is to identify the most dominant parenting style practiced by students' parents in Malacca. And the third is investigate the relationship between parenting style, self-concept, and peer influence and student misconduct behavior. Lastly, we would like to investigate the influence of parenting style, self-concept, and peer influence on student misconduct behavior. Just a quick methodology. This study was conducted with a descriptive survey method using questionnaire, and one primary school and one secondary school in the Tanjung Kling district, Malacca, were selected, and a total of 250 students will participate in this study, and this instrument recorded a satisfactory reliability and validities. Moving on to the result, as you can see, this is our respondent demographic, and you can see that the male and female are equally stable, balanced, same as for the primary school student and secondary school student, and majority of the students, their parents are still in marriage. Next is the descriptive analysis of the research variables, which I would like to emphasize on it. And the first research variable is the misconduct behavior. We have three dimensions: physical, verbal, and mischievous. And as you can see, that generally the mean score by the misconduct behavior is at the low level because it's recorded 1.4 something generally. And the scale for this misconduct behavior is a 5 scale Likert, meaning 1.4 over 5. So it's very considered a low level, which is something that we would like to hear that. And among the three dimensions, the physical dimension of misconduct behavior recorded the highest. However, it doesn't bring any alarming or serious attentions because the level of misconduct behavior among our students is still at low level. And the next is about the self-concept. And the self-concept is generally 3 point something of the mean out of 5, meaning that they are at a moderate level of self-concept. And I will have to highlight the highest, the ethics and the morals dimension of self-concept. This means that the students, they have satisfactory abilities to discriminate between do and does, right and wrong. And they are also ready to change for any mistake actually. So moving on to our next variables is the parenting style. As you can see, there is a variance here, and the highest it means called by is the authoritative parenting style, which this is a very healthy parenting style and very encouraged, a very favorable parenting style. And this simply implies that the students, they are actually nurtured in a healthy family environment whereby the family system has clear sets of rules, structures, and boundaries. And the students, they have their own autonomies to make decisions, of course, with the consensus of their parents and discussions with their parents. And the next, we can look on the peer influence, and the positive peer influence recorded the highest, 3.66 out of 5. This simply just means that students, they did have a moderate levels of positive peer influence, and they have the clear boundaries between themselves and their peers. And put it in another way, and because it's at a moderate levels, and students are not emotionally fused, meaning overfused with their peers, and they have definite beliefs and values. However, the mean score also implies that they may tend to be over concerned on how the other view them. This is because simply because students, they at their age, they are exploring their social identities. So they are very concerned about how other people view and how they behave, and the other people accept their behavior or accept them if they did something wrong or out of the peers norm, peer group norm, they might be isolated. So this is something that they are very concerned about. And as you can see, the things, the self-concept, the dimension of ethics and moral, authoritative and positive that I highlighted actually could explain why the misconduct behavior by our respondent are recorded generally low. So moving on to our next findings, which is the correlation analysis between parenting style and misconduct behavior. And we note that the permissive parenting style have a significant correlation with the misconduct behavior, and also all the dimensions is a positive correlation, means that the more the parents practice permissive parenting style, the more the students engage with misconduct behavior in verbal dimension, physical and mischievous. However, the strength of the relationship is considerable moderate. And moving on to another findings, it shows that the self-concept and misconduct behavior, these findings only reveals that personal self under the dimension of the personal self dimensions of the self-concept are significantly correlated with the verbal dimension of misconduct behavior. However, the relationship are very weak and is a positive. So moving on to our next findings, which is the peer influence and misconduct behavior. And as here we can see that very obvious negative peer influence have significantly association with our with the misconduct behavior variables, and the relationship is a positive, meaning that the more negative peer influence a students they are in, the more misconduct behavior they will engage. And the relationship show considerably low the strength of the relationship considerably low. As you can see, it's about 0.3 something in overall. And moving on to our next finding, which is our last finding, using a multiple regression analysis by stepwise method. And I would like to highlight to you the model ones, which here show that there is a significant influence on the parenting style, specifically the permissive parenting style on the student misconduct behavior. And the misconduct behavior will explain, as you can see, the R square change here is 13.3%, meaning that the misconduct behavior can be explained 13%, about 13% by the permissive parenting style, which also simply implies that the permissive parenting style influenced 13% on student misconduct behavior. All right, just the last one, conclusions. There are multiple factors involving in addressing the issues of student misconduct behavior. In this study, we only have three factors we explore, but because the misconduct behavior is a very complex issue, it involves not only a single variables, and we hope that our findings would give some information and implication for our parents, teachers, school counselor, and school admin and MOE to come up with a policy or strategy to minimize the misconduct behavior among our students and promote a holistic development in our students. And that's all. Thanks for your attention. These are the reference. And I'm glad that you could spend time with me. And thanks for your time, and see you around.